Hello everyone. Today I'm going to do a maths lesson. Our lesson is data handling. I know that you all have done this lesson in grade 3 and grade 4 also. And in grade 5 also we are doing the information are little bit more in our grade 5 syllabus. So when you hear the word data handling, obviously you know it's about drawing graphs. Normally a graph is a summarized way of representing a group of data. So from the first activity, I will refresh your mind, I'll refresh your memory on how to draw a graph based on the given data. So here in this table, I have given some information collected from a class about the number of sisters and brothers in a family. So here number of sisters and brothers have, here the tally marks, and here the number of students. Students that only have brothers, the number is 8, and I have denoted that number 8 using these lines. The number of times I have shown using the tally marks. Normally tally marks we show 5 by 5. So here the first 5 is drawn here and the remaining 3 is drawn here. 9 students are there that only have sisters, and 8 students are there that have both brothers and sisters, and 5 students are there who do not have both brothers and sisters. When we enter the information in a table like this, we call it as data. So this is a data table. Looking at this data table, we can draw our graph. So the following bar graph shows the above data. Normally putte, when we are drawing a graph, there are two axes, that is the vertical axis and the horizontal axis. In the vertical axis we are showing the numbers, and in the horizontal axis we show the categories. And I have named the vertical axis as the number of students as given in the above table, and the horizontal axis I have named as details of the families. And I have named all the 4 categories here. In the data table, you can see that there are 4 categories and the numbers are given here. So all these categories I have named in the graph. So the first one, students only have brothers. Second one, students only have sisters. Third one, students have both brothers and sisters. The last one, students do not have both brothers and sisters. In this graph, after naming these axes, you can draw your graph using these bars. Normally we call this as a bar. So here you can see the number of students who only have brothers, it's 8. So here when I have drawn this graph, I have shown one student from one score. So the scale here, I have taken the scale of 1 by 1. I have marked this vertical line as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here you can see the largest number given in the table is 9. So according to the number, the largest number given in the table, you can decide on up to which number you are marking the vertical line. So here I have taken one more number than 9, so it is 10. I have drawn the vertical line from 0 to 10. I have numbered from 0 to 10. So I have shown that number 8 here, and there are 9 students that only have sisters. So I have drawn the graph up to 9, the bar up to 9. And the third one, students that have both brothers and sisters, it's 8. So I have shown that number from this third bar. And the last one, students do not have both brothers and sisters, it's 5. I have shown the last one from this bar. Putte, though you mark the graph, though you draw the graph neatly and in a correct way, without naming these axes, you are not getting full marks at an exam. So all these points should be included in a graph to obtain full marks. Name the vertical axis and put the numbers here. Name the horizontal axis and name all the categories as given in the data table. And here, remember, I have represent only one student from one score. So this is about drawing a graph. And I have given you few questions so that you will understand how to obtain information from the graph. So the first question is, how many students have only brothers? So looking at the graph or the table, the data table, you can answer them. Students that only have brothers, it's 8. Or looking at the graph, you can say there are 8 students who have only brothers. The second question, how many students do not have both brothers and sisters? So again, you can look at the graph or the data table and give the answer. How many students do not have both brothers and sisters? So it's the last bar. Students do not have both brothers and sisters. It's 5. How many students have both brothers and sisters? Students have both brothers and sisters. It's 8. So there are 8 students who have both brothers and sisters. Then the last one. What is the total number of students here? When they ask for the total number of students, you need to add all these numbers given here. So when you add 8 plus 9 plus 8 plus 5, the answer is 30. So the total number of students in this class is 30. Likewise, you can draw a graph and answer the questions looking at the data table or the graph. So when you are drawing a graph, keep in your mind all the points I told you, that is to name the axis and put the numbers here, name the vertical line and name the horizontal line as this, as given in the data table, and also name all the categories here given as in the data table. So if you include all these points in a graph, you can obtain full marks at an exam. So hope now you understand how to draw a graph using the data given. But in the first session, we discussed how to draw a graph using the data given. So in this activity 2, I'm going to teach you to take different scales and draw a graph. We'll move into the activity. The following table shows information about the pets that 5D students like to have. Here, the pets are given and the number of students who like the pets are also given in the table. 18 students like dogs, 17 likes cats, and 15 like squirrels, 12 like parrots, and 14 like mynas. And I have shown these data in this bar graph. So first, name the two axes. The vertical axis has number of students, and horizontal axis has pets, and named all the pets given. Now you can see the scaling is little bit different than the first graph. Because if you look at the table carefully, you can see the highest number is 18 here. Now imagine you are going to represent one student from one score. Then to show this, to represent this 18 in your writing book, that means in your score rule book, you'll have to draw a little bit longer graph upward. That means when you are drawing this bar upwards, you need to draw a little bit long one, then your graph will be bigger. Then you won't have enough space to name these axes and name all these categories as given in the data table. So what I have done in this graph is I have changed the scales. I have represented 2 students from one score. So I have numbered this vertical line 2 by 2, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and I have taken one more, that is, one more means there are the 2 by 2 we have marked, so it's 20. So in this graph, I have marked 18 like this, the bar, and see the number of students who like cats, it's 70. How to mark 17 here? Putte, though you can't see the number 17 here, you know that in between 16 and 18, 17 is there. So by keeping the ruler, you can take the measurement 17 and mark, and you can draw the bar up to 17. See the next one, squirrels, it's 15. Now you can't see here number 15, but it's between 14 and 16. So you can keep the ruler like this and take the measurement and draw the bar up to 15. Likewise, you can complete the graph. Here also, keep in your mind all the points which are necessary to draw a graph. You drew the axis, you named the axis, vertical axis as number of students and the horizontal axis as pets, and you have named all the all these categories by using the names of these pets, animal, that is dogs, cats, squirrels, parrots and minors, and you have numbered this side 2 by 2. So when you are deciding on which scale you must take to draw a graph, you can look at the larger number and then decide. Now if you take 1 by 1, then you need to draw to denote the number of students who like dogs, you need to take 18 scores to show the number of students who like dogs. So as I told, then your graph would be little bit longer, a bigger one. So in order to avoid that, we have taken different scales in drawing this graph. But here also I have given you few questions based on this graph. So we'll see what kind of questions are these. Which pet do they like the most? So you need to find the answer from this graph, or from the table also you can find the answer. So at once when you see this graph, you can see most number of students like dogs. The second one, which pet do they like the least? So when you, least means the lowest one. So you can see it's parrots. How many students like cats more than minor? So here we compare two animals. Here you can see 17 students like cats. Here 14 students like minor. So 17 minus 14, the difference is 3. So 3 more students like cats than minors. Here the fourth one, find the total number of students in 5D class. So you need to find the total number of students in the class. As I said in the activity 1, you can add all these numbers, 18 plus 17 plus 15 plus 12 plus 14, the answer is 76. So now I hope you understood how to take different scales to make your graph very short and sweet, and how to answer the given questions using the graph or the given data table. In activity 1, I taught you how to draw a graph using the data given, and in the activity 2, we discussed how to take different scales and draw a graph according to the data given. So in the activity 3 also it is same like that, but another new question is there. We'll see what is that. Here the following table shows the number of newspapers sold within a week in a shop. So 5 days are given and number of newspapers sold on each day is given here. So 30 newspapers were sold on Monday, 40 on Tuesday, 50 on Wednesday, 40 on Thursday and 45 on Friday. So draw a graph to represent the above data. Draw a bar graph to represent the above data. Here it's given where one square represents 5 newspapers. Now in the first activity, one square represented 1 student. In the second, one square represented 2 students. Here, why I have asked you to represent 5 newspapers from one square? Because when you look at these numbers, you can understand all these are multiplication of 5. So when you represent 5 newspapers from one square, then you have to number this vertical axis 5 by 5, that is starting from 0 0 5 10 15 20, like so on. So here the largest number is 50. So now imagine you have drawn the graph as one square represents 2 newspapers. Then to show these 50 newspapers, you need to draw this bar. You need to take 25 squares to show these 50. So that is also little bit big, And definitely you don't have enough enough space to show this graph in your writing books, because you have smaller books, so you can't draw that much of bigger graph in your SCAR rule book. So that's why I have changed the scales here. That's why I have asked you to show 5 newspapers from 1 SCAR. So if you take 5x5 to show this 50, you only need 10 SCARs. So likewise, you can draw the graph using the given scale. Draw the two axes, that is the vertical axis and the horizontal axis. Number the axes 5x5. In all the graph, you need to start the numbering using 0. So 5x5, you need to mark it and write the name the vertical axis as number of newspapers sold, and the horizontal axis as the days. So, and you can show all the days here as Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. Normally in a vertical axis we show the numbering, and in the horizontal axis we show the names or the days given or the names of the students or the names of the pet animals, like that. So here you must decide on the scale based on the given data. First you must consider the numbers given here, and you must decide what is the scale I should take here to draw the graph, because my graph should be very short and nice. So what is the scale, what is the number I should represent from 1 SCAR? You should decide it based on the given data. And here another new question is given. Make 5 sentences using the above data. Now in the previous graph I gave you questions to answer. Here I have asked you to make your sentences using this graph and the data table. So looking at these two, you can make your own sentences. The first one I have given, the most number of newspapers were sold on Wednesday. You can see 50 newspapers were sold on Wednesday. Here I have used the word the most. Second one, the least number of newspapers were sold on Monday. That means the lowest one. It's on Monday, that is 30 newspapers. So the least number of newspapers were sold on Monday. Third one, now you can see on Tuesday and Thursday they have sold equal number of newspapers, that is 40. So equal number of newspapers were sold on Tuesday and Thursday. And the fourth one, 15 newspapers were sold on Friday than Monday. So here you can see Friday they have sold 45 newspapers and Monday only 30. So 45 minus 30 is it's 15. The difference is 15. So 15 more newspapers were sold on Friday than Monday. I have compared those 2 days here and converted it into a complete sentence. So the last one, the total number of newspapers sold within the week is 205. How I got 205 is I have added all these numbers given here, that is 30 plus 40 plus 50 plus 40 plus 45 is 205. It's not a very difficult thing to make your own sentences, own complete sentences, because I have used very simple words here in making sentences. Here the first one I have used the most number of, in the second one the least number of, third one equal number of, fourth one I have compared 2 days and I have given it, I have used the word here than, and in the fifth one I have used the word the total number of. So if you keep these simple words in your mind, you can make complete correct sentences looking at a graph. So I'll just recall what we learned here. In the first activity, in the first session, we learned how to draw a graph, and in the second activity we learned how to take different scales and draw, how to draw the graph very short and sweet. And in the third activity I taught you how to draw a graph given to a larger number. That means we wanted to show 50, so there I represented 5 newspapers from 1 SCAR. And there I taught you how to make complete sentences looking at a graph using these simple words: most number of, least number of, equal number of, and then and the word the total number of. So now you can refer into your textbook activities and do all the exercises there under the topic data handling.